Welcome to IEPs, one of a series of workshops that will help you understand and navigate the school system for your child. For more information, check out the Parent Pages section. In this workshop, we'll take a closer look at the process of adapting, modifying, and providing accommodations for a child needing extra help within the education system in the province of Ontario. This workshop will help you to understand and prepare yourself for your role in this process. Many students require curriculum modifications or program accommodations to be successful in the regular school program. If your child needs changes made to their program to help them learn, an IEP may be written. IEP stands for Individual Education Plan. It is a formal, written plan of learning goals and expectations that will provide support for the student's learning and development, as well as help guide the teacher in doing this. These goals and expectations may differ from those set out in the Ontario curriculum. An IEP describes the strengths and needs of the student, the special education program, and services available to meet that student's needs, and how the program and services will be delivered. IEPs are for students who have learning needs that require extra support. Schools must provide an IEP for any child who has been identified as exceptional and placed through the Identification Placement Review Committee, or IPRC, process. According to regulations, the IEP is to be completed within 30 school days of the start of the placement. This is usually at the start of the school year. If your child's placement is in the regular classroom, the IEP will be especially important. If your child has not had an IPRC and is attending the regular classroom, your child can still receive an IEP. You or your child's teacher can do this by making the request in writing to the school principal. Principals are required to make sure that, as a parent or guardian, you are consulted and have a role in the setting of the IEP goals. You know your child best and can give input into what works well for your child. Consultation with everyone involved in the education of your child is important in creating a successful plan. The Ontario Ministry of Education's IEP Resource Guide and the Shared Solutions documents can give you more information on the cooperative approach that should be used. After the IEP is developed, it is important to continue to work together to make the plan as successful as possible. It should be referred to regularly and reviewed at every report card time. The IEP must be reviewed at each report card time and revised to describe progress or to modify goals. For example, goals may be broken down into smaller steps to encourage greater progress. It is important to note that the grade on the report card for subjects identified in the IEP should be based on the learning goals in the IEP. Let's look at an IEP. The IEP begins by showing if the student has or has not been identified through the IPRC process. Page 1 also includes information about the student, the exceptionality as stated in the IPRC, the placement decision, relevant medical or assessment data, areas of strength and need. This area should include teacher observation and your own input about your child and the strengths and needs as stated in the IPRC. The next page of the IEP lists the subjects or skill areas to which the IEP applies based on the Ontario Ministry of Education curriculum. This will identify whether each subject or goal in the IEP will differ from the Ontario curriculum by applying an accommodation, by being modified, or by applying an alternative. Let's take a closer look at what that means. Accommodated refers to adaptations needed for the student to work at the same level as other students in the grade on that subject or course. Accommodations help a student get all of the information and materials offered by the teacher and help the teacher get a better understanding of what the student has learned. For example, your child may need more time to write tests or may need the use of a computer in class. Modified refers to changes made to subjects or courses to meet the needs of a student. When modifications are made, the expectations for that student will differ from the regular grade expectations in content, amount, or complexity. The student may also need specific accommodations for modified subjects or courses. Alternative refers to programs that help a student to develop skills and knowledge and are not part of the usual schoolwork. Examples of alternative programs include speech and language therapy, occupational therapy, behavior management, or personal care programs. The IEP goals and learning expectations are written in such a way that your child's teacher and you, as the parent or guardian, are able to understand exactly what they mean. They should be observable and measurable. Goals and learning expectations should also give details about the methods and strategies the teacher will use, how the student's knowledge will be assessed, the student's current level of achievement from which progress is measured, and the human resources needed to carry out the plan. Students 14 years of age or older who have been identified through the IPRC process will also have a transition plan as part of their IEP. The purpose of this plan is to ensure that the student is prepared to meet post-secondary goals, such as work, further education, and life in the community. Transition plans must contain specific goals that are realistic and reflect the strengths, needs, and interests of the student, the actions required now and in the future to achieve these goals, the person, people, or agency responsible or involved in completing or assisting in the completion of each goal, timelines for the implementation for each of the identified actions. This process and other helpful information about IEPs is outlined in both School Board and the Ontario Ministry of Education websites. Take time to review the information and ask questions. Remember that your role as a parent in preparing and helping carry out the goals of the IEP is most important. You will be able to help everyone involved get a clear understanding of your child and support the school in taking the steps needed to build success for your child. Thanks for stopping by.